Ali, and now the real thing is starting. So we will see and we will work together with Elisabeth II, and we'll see exactly how she pronounced, because you will see that it's extremely, extremely interesting. So as usual, we will see few things. It will be like dictations, like we did previously. I will start nicely, because it's always important to just take the time. Just take the time to listen, to get used to her pace, to her pronunciation. So we will do it like that, as we did previously, by the way. So we will listen it several times. So I will let it roll and then try to write the missing words. D'accord? On y va.
Je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois. Je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois. Je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois. Je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois. Je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois.
Allez-y. Alors, voilà, oui, I can see that you can catch quite well the thing. Victoria Jacques wanted to revolutionize the conjugation of the verb rappeler. It's a verb, Victoria Jacques, you don't keep it like that. Cassandra, it's the same, hein? People want to play with the verb rappeler. Alors, let's have a look at, well, what she says and the way she pronounces. On y va.
Je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois.
In fact, she doesn't really have an accent. Well, she has the British accent, but in fact, the British accent is extremely subtle. It's not really strong when people master as well as she does. So it is really clear. As you can see, she's got her own pace. She doesn't go too fast, which is quite good. Of course, she's reading. You can feel that she's reading, but it's extremely, extremely clear. So there is really nothing to say with the pronunciation. It's really, really clean. Let's listen to it one more time. So I would pronounce it: je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois. D'accord? Let's listen to her pronunciation.
Je me rappelle le plaisir que j'ai eu à découvrir ce beau pays pour la première fois.
And the interesting thing is that in many cases, English speaking persons can struggle with this U sound, because we've got the U and we've got the U, but she really masters to pronounce it perfectly. So it's really good. It's really good. Let's have a look at the second thing. On y va. Attention, je clique. Ah! Voilà.
Et à cultiver à mon tour une grande affection pour le peuple français. Et à cultiver à mon tour une grande affection pour le peuple français. Et à cultiver à mon tour une grande affection pour le peuple français. Et à cultiver à mon tour une grande affection pour le peuple français. Et à cultiver à mon tour une grande affection pour le peuple français.
Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Alors, I can see that you can catch it quite well, in fact, so félicitations. So, let's have a look at what she says. Et à cultiver, so in that case it should be definitely in the infinitive form, à mon tour. Hein? So let's see exactly how she pronounces. So I would pronounce it, et à cultiver, à mon tour, une grande affection pour le peuple français. Attention, on y va.
Et à cultiver à mon tour une grande affection pour le peuple français.
It is really good. It is really good because the only thing that maybe she could have some difficulty with would be once again the UU from cultiver, but she's pronouncing it perfectly. Et à cultiver.
Et à cultiver à mon tour une grande affection. Pour le peuple français.
Yeah, and what you can see also that in fact this tour, I mean the final R is extremely subtle. It's really nicely done because she doesn't go with the R, I mean the R that could come from English, not at all, and she doesn't fall in the trap of going for the R like that too much. It's really, really subtle. So let's get it one more time.
Et à cultiver à mon tour. Une grande affection pour le peuple français.
No, it's really good. It is really good. Allez, on continue. On continue. Number three. On y va. Numéro trois. Let's go for it. Try to find the missing words. So it's up to you. I am putting the missing words. If you want to write the full sentence, it is up to you. But I know that we've got different levels in the group. So if you only want to focus on the words, no problem. If you want to write the full sentence, go for it.
Nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur. Nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur. Nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur. Nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur.
Allez, please write the things. Alors, Mice Flag is saying, bonjour, j'habite au Canada. She's the queen of Canada. Bah oui, and that's the reason why she needs to address to the, well, I mean, Canadian people in French also. So this is one of the reasons why she speaks quite well French. And so let me check. Yep, you start to write, which is quite good. So hop là, let's have a look at the words. And so we're looking for compatriote, that should be in the plural form, toujours. I mean, you've been catching it quite well. Mélange, remember that in that case it's the substantive, hein, so un mélange. Amitié, so it's a noun. Une amitié, feminine. Rivalité, it's also a noun and it's feminine. And humeur, it's also a noun and it's feminine. So as you can see, and I think that once again she's been pronouncing extremely, extremely well. So let's see if I can find some things to say.
Nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur.
Alors, the only thing I could find it's compatriote. I felt that there was this M, but it was really subtle. So,
nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur.
It is really good. Huh? It is really good. So this "on" from Compatriot, I can feel a little M, but really it's so subtle that, I mean, it's not really a big thing. So "non com," I will pronounce it, and she will pronounce it. Victoria Jacques, maybe she will say Tigidou. No, I was expecting for the Tigidou to come at one point, because we will have something related to Canada. She didn't go for the Tigidou, and I was a bit disappointed, I must say. Alors, I would pronounce it. Nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur. Attention, on écoute.
Nos compatriotes retrouvent toujours ce mélange unique d'amitié, de rivalité dans la bonne humeur.
Voilà. And she was addressing, and she was talking in that case, obviously, about the relationship between French people and English people, because, of course, we love each other, but we hate each other too. So this is, the relationship between French people and English people. On y va. Attention, attention.
Ainsi que l'admiration qui constitue l'essence des liens qui unissent la Grande-Bretagne et la France. Ainsi que l'admiration qui constitue l'essence des liens qui unissent la Grande-Bretagne et la France. Ainsi que l'admiration qui constitue l'essence des liens qui unissent la Grande-Bretagne et la France. Ainsi que l'admiration qui constitue l'essence des liens qui unissent la Grande-Bretagne et la France.
Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Sorry, I just noticed that the "e" was missing to Grande Bretagne. It was just an accident. I didn't want to be mean with the country. Alors, let's have a look at the things that we're looking for. So the first one was ainsi. Ainsi, you've been writing it, yes, quite well. So A-I, N-S-I. And so remember, it's this nasal A-I-N-1-1-1. Ainsi, ainsi. Admiration, well, once again, feminine noun, ending with ion. Not really tricky to write. Hein? After that, essence. So remember that essence is feminine. L'essence. Une essence. Lien, it's in the plural form here, but it's a masculine noun. Un lien, le lien, in that case, the plural. Unis, it's the verb unir. So remember, verb unir, it's a verb from the second group, regular group. J'unis, I-S, tu unis, I-S, il unit, I-T. Nous unissons, vous unissez, ils unissent, elles unissent. So remember, E-N-T in the end, you don't pronounce it. So, this is the way it goes. Ainsi que l'admiration qui constitue. So I've been putting this plural, because I was not really sure, and it's extremely difficult to know exactly if she refers to something else than l'admiration, and I think she does, so I was not sure, I wanted to put that as an option. L'essence des liens qui unissent la Grande-Bretagne et la France. So let's have a look at the way she pronounces it.
Ainsi que l'admiration qui constitue l'essence des liens qui unissent la Grande-Bretagne et la France.
It is really good. It is really, really, really good. I mean, she's got a really great pronunciation, so nothing to say in that case. Nothing to say at all. Numéro 5. Numéro 5, on y va. So same thing. Find the missing words, or then you can write the full sentence if you want.
Les hommes, depuis toujours, entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales. Les hommes, depuis toujours, entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales. Les hommes, depuis toujours, entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales. Les hommes,
depuis toujours, entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales. Les hommes, depuis toujours, entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales.
Allez-y. Alors, Stella is joining us. Bonjour Stella, Soukania aussi. Bonjour, bonsoir. Alors, you might have noticed that this is from another track. So basically, the sound is not as great because it's an old one, I guess. It's from the 70s or, well, late 70s, I guess. She was visiting Canada at that time. So let's have a look at the thing one more time. So the first one, it was les hommes. So hommes, in that case, it should be in a plural form with the final S. Depuis, you've been writing it quite well. D-E-P-U-I-S. Entretiennent, so it's the verb, once again, entretenir. Entretenir, connected to tenir, hein, remember. Tenir, je tiens, tu tiens, il, elle tient. Nous tenons, vous tenez, il, elle tiennent. T-I-E-N-N-E-N-T. So in that case, you just put the prefix entre, entretiennent. And then finally, fondamental, as you can see, it's an adjective. The adjective should definitely be in the feminine form because it's connected to aspiration. Aspiration, feminine noun. In the plural, in that case, so it goes fondamental, F-O-N-D-A-M-E-N-T-A-L-E-S. Fondamental. So let's check the way she pronounces it, and then we will see if we have something to say or not.
Les hommes, depuis toujours, entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales.
Well, it's interesting because there is a gap between the two things that we've been listening to. The first part was clearly coming later, and she had, and now she has a perfect accent. In that case, I can feel the nasal, but it's because I really want to find something to say.
Les hommes, depuis toujours, entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales.
Wait, fondamental, I would say it slightly differently, but really it's I mean it is really really perfect. So les hommes depuis toujours entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales. Let's check if he makes the liaison.
Les hommes depuis toujours entretiennent trois aspirations fondamentales.
Eh oui, and she makes the liaison. It is perfect. It's perfect. Félicitations. Numéro 6, let's continue with this one. This one is a bit more tricky because now you've got to write everything.
Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada. Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada. Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada. Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada. Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada. Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada.
Allez-y, try to write the sentence. Alors, Nisha didn't know she spoke French. Well, she has to because, Canada is bilingual, so one of the languages is French. So I guess it's one of the reasons. And then it's the language of the historical enemy, so you need to speak the language of the enemy. Alors, let's have a look at the thing. So, ils ont fini par former. So this one, I think it was quite clear, in fact. Let's listen to it. So the beginning was in fact, quite, well, let's hope so, quite clear. Once again. Oops. Pardon.
Ils ont fini par former.
I think this is quite clear. Ils ont fini par former. She's going quite fast, in fact. It's interesting because, well, in the previous things that we had, I mean, she was not going that fast. But let's take the time. Ils ont fini par former.
Ils ont fini par former.
This is good. So after that, l'étoffe même. So of course it refers to this word. If you don't know the word une étoffe, well, now you do. Une étoffe, l'étoffe même. Alors attendez, on y va. L'étoffe même. How does she pronounce that?
L'étoffe même.
Ouais, this is good. The T is interesting. It's so beautiful because it's like she's got this little accent, but it's really nice.
Former, l'étoffe même.
Oui, the T. T, as you can see, it's not that strong as I would do it, like that. It's like a bit rounder. So let's listen to it one more time.
Former, l'étoffe même du Canada.
Voilà, and then Canada, well. Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada. It's really great, I mean, the way she pronounces it. So let's go for it one more time.
Ils ont fini par former l'étoffe même du Canada.
Voilà, that's it. Eh bien, merci.